Your honour's players now are come to play a pleasant comedy, for so our doctors hold it very meet. Seeing too much sadness doth congeal the blood, and melancholy is the nurse of frenzy. Therefore we thought it good you hear a play, and frame your mind to mirth and merriment, which bars a thousand harms and lengthens life.
Fenella Fielding as Catherine and Paul Daneman as Petruchio in The Taming of the Shrew by William Shakespeare.
Tranio, since for the great desire I had to see fair Padua, nursery of arts, I am arrived for fruitful Lombardy, the pleasant garden of great Italy, and by my father's love and leave am armed with his good will and thy good company. My trusty servant, well approved in all. Here, let us breathe, and haply institute a course of learning and ingenious studies.
Oh, mi per donato, gentle master mine. I am in all affected as yourself. Only good master, while we do admire this virtue and this moral discipline, let's be no stoics nor stocks, I pray. No profit grows where is no pleasure taste.
Gramercy, Strania, well dost thou advise. The Andello now were come ashore, we could at once put us in readiness and take a lodging fit to entertain such friends as time in Padua shall beget. But stay a while. What company is this?
Master, some show to welcome us to town.
Gentlemen, importune me no further. For how I firmly am resolved, you know. That is not to bestow my youngest daughter before I have a husband or the elder. If either of you both love Katharina, because I know you well and love you well, leave shall you have to court her at your pleasure.
Court her, rather. She's too rough for me. Potentio, will you anyway?
I pray you, sir, is it your will to make a stale of me amongst these mates?
Mates made? How mean you that? No mates for you, unless you are of gentler, milder mould.
Hortensio, you shall never need to fear. I wish it is not halfway to her heart. But if it were, doubt not her care should be to comb your noddle with a three-legged stool, and paint your face, and use you like a fool.
From all such devils, good Lord, deliver us.
And me too, good Lord.
Master, here's some good pastime toward. That wench is stark mad, or wonderful froward.
But in the other's silence do I see maids' mild behavior and sobriety.
Gentlemen, that I may soon make good what I have said, Bianca, get you in. And let it not displease thee, good Bianca, for I will love thee nevertheless, my girl.
A pretty pet. It is best put finger in the eye and she knew why.
Oh, sister, content you in my discontent. Mm. Sir, to your pleasure humbly I subscribe. My books and instruments shall be my company. On them to look and practice by myself.
Oh, hark, Tranio, thou mayst hear Minerva speak.
Signor Baptista, will you be so strange?
Why will you mew her up, Signor Baptista, for this fiend of hell?
What?
And make her bear the penance of her tongue?
Gentlemen, content ye, I am resolved. Go in, Bianca.
Oh, Father. I obey.
Father, I obey.
And for I know she taketh most delight in music, instruments, and poetry, schoolmasters will I keep within my house, fit to instruct her youth. If you, Hortensio, or Signor Gremio, know any such, prefer them hither, for to cunning men I will be very kind and liberal to mine own children in good bringing up. And so, farewell. Katharina, you may stay, for I have more to commune with Bianca.
And I trust I may go, too, may I not? What shall I be appointed hours? As though belike I knew not what to take and what to leave. Oh!
You may go to the devil's dam. Your gifts are so good, as none will hold you. Farewell, Hortensio. Yet for the love I bear my sweet Bianca, if I can by any means light on a fit man, to teach her that wherein she delights, I will wish him to her father.
So will I, Signor Gremio. But a word, I pray.
Yeah.
Though the nature of our quarrel yet never brooked parle, now it toucheth us both to labour and effect one thing specially.
What's that, I pray?
Marry, sir, to get a husband for her sister.
A husband? A devil?
I say a husband.
I say a devil. Since thou, Hortensio, though her father be very rich, any man is so very a fool to be married to hell.
Hush, Gremio. Though it pass your patience and mine to endure her loud alarums, why, man, there be good fellows in the world, and a man could light on them, could take her with all faults, and money enough.
Oh, I cannot tell, but I had as lief take her dowry with this condition, to be whipped at the High Cross every morning.
Faith, as you say, there's small choice in rotten apples. But come, by helping Baptista's eldest daughter to a husband, we set his youngest free for a husband, and then have to it afresh. How say you, Signor Gremio?
Yes, I am agreed. And would I had given him the best horse in Padua to begin his wooing, that would thoroughly woo her, wed her, feed her, and rid the housework. Come along.
I pray, sir, tell me, is it possible that love should of a sudden take such hold?
Oh, Tranio, till I found it to be true, I never thought it possible or likely. But see, while idly I stood looking on, I found the effect of love in idleness. No. Oh, Tranio, I burn, I pine, I perish, Tranio, if I achieve not this young, modest girl.
Master, you looked so longly on the maid, perhaps you marked not what's the pith of all.
Oh, yes, I saw sweet beauty in her face.
Saw you no more? Marked you not how her sister began to scold and raise up such a storm that mortal ears might hardly endure the din?
Tranio, I saw her coral lips to move, and with her breath she did perfume the air. Sacred and sweet was all I saw in her.
Nay, then 'tis time to stir him from this trance. I pray awake, sir. Mm. If you love the maid, bend thoughts and wits to achieve her. Thus it stands. Her elder sister is so cursed and shrewd that till the father rid his hands of her, master, your love must live a maid at home. And therefore has he closely mewed her up, because he will not be annoyed with suitors.
Ah, Tranio, what a cruel father's he. But art thou not advised he took some care to get her cunning schoolmasters to instruct her?
Aye, marry, I am, sir. And now 'tis plotted.
I have it, Tranio.
Master for my hand. Both our inventions meet and jump in one.
Tell me thine first.
You will be schoolmaster and undertake the teaching of the maid. That's your device.
It is. May it be done?
Not possible. For who shall bear your part? And be in Padua here Vincentio's son. Keep house and ply his book, welcome his friends, visit his countrymen and banquet them.
Master, content thee, for I have it full.
Mm?
We have not yet been seen in any house, nor can we be distinguished by our faces for man or master. Then it follows thus. Thou shalt be master, Tranio, in my stead. Keep house and port and servants as I should. 'Tis hatched and shall be so. Tranio, at once, uncase thee. Take my coloured hat and cloak. When Biondello comes, he waits on thee. But I will charm him first to keep his tongue.
So had you need. In brief, sir, sith it your pleasure is, and I am tired to be obedient, for so your father charged me at our parting, I am content to be Lucentio, because so well I love Lucentio.
Tranio, be so because Lucentio loves. And let me be a slave to achieve that maid whose sudden sight hath thralled my wounded eye. Here comes Biondello.
Oh, sirrah, where have you been?
Where have I been? Nay, how now? Where are you? Master, has my fellow Tranio stolen your clothes? Or you stolen his, or both? Pray, what's the news?
Sirrah, come hither. 'Tis no time to jest. Your fellow Tranio here... Yeah. To save my life puts my apparel and my countenance on, and I, for my escape, have put on his.
Aye.
For in a quarrel, since I came ashore, I killed a man. And fear I was descried. Wait you on him, I charge you, as becomes, while I make way from hence to save my life. You understand me?
Aye, sir. Near a wit.
And not a jot of Tranio in your mouth. Tranio is changed into Lucentio.
The better for him. Would I wear so too?
Tranio, let's go. One thing more rests that thyself execute, to make one among these wooers.
Aye?
If thou ask me why, sufficeth my reasons are both good and weighty.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.